Hi and welcome to CardioEd. Today's topic of discussion is CTCR MVS trial or concomitant tricuspid repair in patients with degenerative mitral regurgitation. It was recently published in New England Journal of Medicine in November 2021 and it was presented at the AHA meeting 2021 also. Tricuspid regurgitation can be primary or secondary. Tricuspid regurgitation is secondary in more than 90% of the cases, where it is usually due to left-sided valvular heart disease or myocardial disease. Tricuspid regurgitation is very common in patients with severe degenerative mitral regurgitation. Severe tricuspid regurgitation is associated with impaired survival and worsening heart failure. The standard practice is that severe tricuspid regurgitation should be addressed during the left heart surgery. This is because severe tricuspid regurgitation might not improve after the surgery. And second, severe tricuspid regurgitation can also develop late after the left-sided valve surgery. And late reoperation for severe tricuspid regurgitation carries high perioperative mortality. The current recommendation is, in patients with primary TR or primary tricuspid regurgitation, surgery is recommended if the patient is symptomatic. And for asymptomatic severe tricuspid regurgitation, intervention should be considered if RV dilatation and RV dysfunction is present. For patients with secondary tricuspid regurgitation, European Society of Cardiology 2021 guidelines state that in patients with secondary TR, tricuspid repair should be performed liberally during the left-sided surgery. The recommendation is largely based on the observational data and also on the facts that tricuspid repair does not increase the operative risk, it improves functional status, and it promotes reverse remodeling of right ventricle. So, how do we surgically correct tricuspid regurgitation? Valve repair is always preferable to replacement in patients with TR. How do we repair it? So, aneuroplasty with prosthetic ring is the most common method for repair. When do we take up the patients for tricuspid replacement, tricuspid valve replacement? Tricuspid valve replacement is done when annulus is severely dilated and leaflets are tethered. What to do when the patients have mild or moderate TR? So, what is known is that surgical and medical treatment of left-sided disease decreases the severity of TR. Mild to moderate TR that is not corrected at the time of left heart cardiac surgery may progress in approximately 25% of the cases. And this is associated with decreased survival. In which patients does this progression to severe TR occur? It is usually seen in the patients where the annular diameter is more than 40 millimeters or it is more than 21 millimeters per meter square body surface area on transthoracic echocardiography, or RV dysfunction is present, or leaflet teeth ring is present, or pulmonary hypertension is present, or atrial fibrillation is present, or where there are pacing or ICD leads across the tricuspid valve. Small studies have shown that in patients with moderate or less than moderate tricuspid regurgitation with annular dilatation leads to lesser progression of tricuspid regurgitation and better outcomes. So, why aren't we doing it regularly? This is because of the certain risks which are associated with tricuspid valve repair. And these include increased permanent pacemaker implantation and number two, increased cardiopulmonary bypass time. Practice varies from center to center while managing less than severe TR in patients undergoing left-sided valvular heart disease surgery. The number of patients who undergo tricuspid repair during mitral valve surgery varies between 5% to 75% in different centers. The current study is done to fill in the knowledge gap that what should be the best strategy for management of patients with less than severe tricuspid regurgitation undergoing mitral valve surgery. It included approximately 400 patients undergoing mitral valve surgery for degenerative mitral regurgitation, and these patients were randomly assigned to two groups. One group underwent mitral valve surgery with tricuspid annuloplasty and the other group underwent mitral valve surgery alone. What were the endpoints? The primary endpoint was a composite of reoperation for tricuspid regurgitation, progression of tricuspid regurgitation, or death. And the secondary endpoints were death, major adverse cardiovascular and cerebrovascular events, permanent pacemaker implantation, duration of hospitalization, residual tricuspid regurgitation, right ventricular size and functions, NYHA functional class, diuretic use, 6-minute walk distance, quality of life, serious adverse events, and rehospitalization. The mean age of the patients was around 68 years, and 75% of the total participants were males. More than 90% patients were whites. More than 90% patients had severe mitral regurgitation. Of these patients, approximately 90% patients underwent mitral valve repair, whereas 10% patients underwent mitral valve replacement. Moderate tricuspid regurgitation was present in approximately 40% patients. Tricuspid annular diameter was measured on the apical forechamber, and average tricuspid annular diameter was 42 millimeters. Around 90% patients had normal RV functions. More than 50% patients in both the groups underwent concomitant cardiac procedure, for example, coronary artery bypass grafting, atrial fibrillation ablation, left atrial appendage closure, and PFO closure. The authors found that the patients who had moderate or less than moderate TR who had received tricuspid annuloplasty at the time of surgery for degenerative MR had significantly lower primary endpoint, that is composite of reoperation for tricuspid regurgitation, progression of tricuspid regurgitation, and death. This was primarily due to lesser incidence of tricuspid regurgitation progression among the patients who are assigned to tricuspid annuloplasty. Progression of TR was only limited to the patients who had moderate TR. And what was interesting to note is that major adverse cardiovascular and cerebrovascular events, functional status, heart failure events, quality of life, heart failure hospitalization, diuretic use was similar in both the groups, those who underwent tricuspid annuloplasty and those who did not. The rate of permanent pacemaker implantation was higher in the patients who received tricuspid annuloplasty. Patients in the tricuspid annuloplasty group had higher cardiopulmonary bypass time. On an average, these patients required 34 extra minutes of cardiopulmonary bypass time. Tricuspid annuloplasty increased the duration of stay in the hospital. As we have discussed, the rate of pacemaker implantation was higher in the tricuspid annuloplasty group. Of these pacemakers implanted, 80% of the pacemakers were implanted during the index hospitalization. Permanent pacemaker implantation in these patients is associated with increased risk of current and progressive TR, device malfunction, device thrombosis, or device infection. But the authors concluded from the study was that among patients who were undergoing mitral valve surgery, those who had received tricuspid annuloplasty had lower incidence of primary endpoint events than those who underwent mitral valve surgery alone at 2 years. And this was primarily driven by lesser frequency of progression to severe TR. Another way to look at these results is that aggressive treatment for less than severe TR is not usually warranted. If less than severe TR is left alone, at max, it can show progression in some patients, but treating it does not improve quality of life, does not improve heart failure, does not improve functional status, and increases the chances of permanent pacemaker implantation. Whether the reduced progression of the tricuspid regurgitation, which was seen in this study, result in some long-term clinical benefits can only be seen after the long-term follow-up data is available. You were listening to CardioEd, and we'll meet again in another episode.